Hey, Java developers, JDK 25 has been released. 18 jeps were included in this release. Let's review all these changes in 2 minutes, more or less. JDK 25 was a big release, 4 new features with 11 being added. Let's take a look. Jep 506 adds scoped values. The second major feature from Project Loom, scope values are an immutable value that is available within the specific scope of an application. They can be useful for providing contextual information similar to thread local, though aren't a direct replacement for them. Jep 510 introduces a key derivation function API as a final feature after previewing in JDK 24. The KDF API allows for the creation of additional keys from a secret key and other data. Module imports allow the importing of all the exported API of a module in a single line with import module, module name, like this example here. If you're importing multiple modules that contain the same class name, you can resolve the conflict by explicitly importing the class you are intending to use, like in this example. The key feature of the Paving the OnRamp feature set, compact source files and instance main methods, is finalized with JDK 25. This simplifies the requirements when writing very simple applications, helpful for educational purposes and when writing scripts in Java. Flexible constructor bodies is finalized in JDK 25 with JEP 513. Flexible constructor bodies allow for adding statements before the call to super in a constructor. JEPs 514 and 515 are part of Project Leiden. JEP 514 allows an AOT cache to be created in a single step, a reduction from the two-step process in JDK 25. And 515 allows for method profiling to be added to an AOT cache, improving application warmup. JFR got 2 major updates in JDK 25 with JEPs 518 and 520. JEP 518 improves JFR's ability to by redesigning its thread stack sampling mechanism. JEP 520 improves JFR's ability to time and trace method execution. This works via JFR's events and configuring the methods to be timed and traced, like in this example. The compact headers feature, added as an experimental feature in JDK 24, has been promoted to a final feature in JDK 25. It reduces the minimum size an object header can be, which reduces heap sizes by 10 to 20%. Compressed object headers can be enabled with a JVM arg plus use compact object headers. Generational Shenandoah has been made a final feature in JDK 25 as well. If available on your JDK, it can be enabled with the JVM args plus use Shenandoah GC and Shenandoah GC mode generational. The only feature being removed in JDK 25 is the removal of all code and build support for 32-bit x86 ports with JEP 503. Subsequently, 32-bit OpenJDK binaries will no longer be available starting with the JDK 25 release. There are 6 preview features or experimental features in JDK 25. JEP 470 is a preview API for encoding and decoding objects in the widely used privacy-enhanced mail format. Stable Values provides an API for immutable values that can be treated as constants by the JVM, but offer greater flexibility as to when the value is set than currently provided by the final keyword, which requires the value to be set at either class or instance initialization. The Structured Concurrency API enters 5th preview with JDK 25. This random preview introduces significant changes to the Structured Concurrency API. Be sure to check it out and send us feedback on it. JEP 507 re-previews the primitive types and pattern matching feature, which remains unchanged from its initial previewing in JDK 23. The vector API remains in incubator status and will remain so until Valhalla features are integrated into the mainline JDK. Insert Valhalla when jokes here. JEP 509 introduces a JFR CPU time profiling as an experimental feature, which, as the name suggests, can calculate CPU usage within specific methods in an application. It's only available when running on Linux and is controlled through the JDK CPU time sample event. All right. That's it for the major changes coming in the JDK 25 release. Be sure to check out our Road to JDK 25 playlist, which covers the migration to JDK 25 from 21, as well as more in-depth explanation on key new features, updates, and changes between 21 and 25. Until next time, happy coding!